So does vitamin D help combat coronavirus? I've got your answers. There are some really interesting findings going on out there about vitamin D, and we're gonna get into it. I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner, and I'm an ER doctor. Make sure you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on. So according to recent research coming out of the Journal of American Medical Association, there was a correlation discovered between vitamin D deficiency and higher risk of COVID-19. Let me repeat, a correlation discovered between vitamin D deficiency and
higher risk of COVID-19.
And another study found that COVID-19 patients who had adequate vitamin D levels had a 51.5% lower risk of dying from the disease and significantly reduced the risk of complications. Let me repeat that. 51.5% lower risk of dying from the disease and significantly reduced the risk of complications. And yet another study in the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism, researchers looked at 216 COVID-19 patients in a hospital in Spain. Of all the patients, 82% were deficient in vitamin D. People who had COVID-19 and lower vitamin D levels also had higher inflammatory markers, such as ferritin and D-dimer. Ferritin is a blood protein that contains iron. A ferritin test helps your doctor understand how much iron your body stores. D-dimer is a protein fragment, a small piece, that's made when a blood clot dissolves in your body. Blood clotting is an important process that prevents you from losing too much blood when you're injured. Normally, your body will dissolve the clot once your injury has healed. We add these blood tests to your lab studies that we order in the ER for any suspected COVID-19 patient. In this study, people with vitamin D deficiency had higher prevalence of hypertension and cardiovascular disease, and they also had longer hospital stays for COVID-19. So, if vitamin D can potentially help fight against COVID-19, how does one get vitamin D? Vitamin D is sometimes called the sunshine vitamin because your body produces vitamin D naturally when it is exposed directly to sunlight. You can also get it through certain foods and supplements to ensure adequate levels of the vitamin in your blood. Vitamin D2 can be found in some mushrooms, and vitamin D3 is found in oily fish, fish liver oil, and egg yolks. What does vitamin D do for your body? Well, in addition to potentially helping combat COVID, like these studies suggest, vitamin D has several important functions in your life. Perhaps the most vital are regulating the absorption of calcium and phosphorus and facilitating normal immune system function. Getting a sufficient amount of vitamin D is important for normal growth and development of bones and teeth, as well as improved resistance against certain diseases. If your body doesn't get enough vitamin D, you're at risk for developing bone abnormalities such as soft bones or osteomalacia, or fragile bones, osteoporosis. What are other surprising benefits of getting enough vitamin D? Number one, reducing your risk of multiple sclerosis, according to a study in 2006 in the Journal of American Medical Association. Number two, decreasing your chance of developing heart disease, according to 2008 findings published in Circulation. Number three, helping reduce your likelihood of developing the flu, according to a 2010 research. Number four, and it can also help fight depression. And lastly, it encourages weight loss. So how much vitamin should you take? Although there is no exact consensus of the dose of vitamin D, you should, of course, always consult your doctor first. The Endocrine Society recommends that children take or receive 600 to 1,000 IUs daily, and adults 600 to 2,000 IUs daily. The amount needed also depends on your current levels or if you're trying to raise them. Also, adults with obesity might need 2 to 3 times more than a normal amount. So what's the takeaway? Medical experts theorize that maintaining adequate vitamin D levels may help lower your risk or aid recovery from severe COVID-19 for some people. At this time, more testing is still needed. All right, that's been a quick COVID and vitamin D breakdown with me, Dr. Wagner. Do you have other COVID questions or other medical topics that you'd like me to discuss? Please let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. Hit me up on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. I'll be sure to respond to you there. And as always, please make sure you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.